In the last video, I showed a 5-element X-yagi antenna for the 70 centimeter band for satellite operation. And as you can see, it is this one, and it has this far field plot. But this is a horizontal polarized. If I choose a vertical polarized, you see that there's no field, and horizontal field is present. However, the satellite tumbles all the time, so you never know what polarization arrives at your antenna. You can do it manually, vertical and horizontal, but that's not very handy, so I would like to add the same antenna on the same boom but with vertical polarization. First we had 5 elements, and now I added another 5 elements. As you can see on the boom, the positions are the same, and I switched the X and the Z, and here the same. I also fed wire 7, and of course you have to divide your power, so it has only half of it. And I added some phase shift, and this is the result. So you now understand why it's called an X-yagi, cross-yagi. These elements are horizontal polarized, and these give the vertical polarization. If you look to the far field plots, you can see here the vertical and here the horizontal diagram, and here both. And as you can see, it is 3 dB less than what you would have when you have only a single X-yagi. That's logical, because half of the power goes to the vertical antenna and half of the power goes to the horizontal antenna. Back to review. As you can see, the elements are exactly at the same position. That's not handy from a constructive point of view. And we, at this moment, we feed the vertical antenna with some quarter wave phase shift. But we can also shift this whole vertical antenna on the boom a quarter wavelength. And then it is constructive, more possible to do, and you don't need a feed line to make the shift, so it's even more handy. So let's try to do this on my homemade small satellite X-yagi. So this is the new antenna. I added one X-yagi on the boom, shifted a quarter wavelength, and the coax cables I just put together like this. In fact, there should be some matching, because if you have two 50 ohm elements via 50 ohm cable connected together, you have only 25 ohm, but it is not really 50 ohm, and well, 25 ohm is still a rather good SWR. So let's test it and see what happens. After adding the two dipoles to this splitter, it's all 50 ohm in, 50 ohm out. You can see with the SWR, this is full scale, and this is return. So that's not much. Very good indeed. If we do the same at 432, forward, you see some more, but not much. I use again the web SDR, some 20 kilometers away. This is my cross X-yagi.
Then I point to the screen and I switch the transmitter on, and I now switch to horizontal and vertical and horizontal and vertical and horizontal and vertical. So it was a nice experiment. You lost some gain compared to a single Yagi with this cross Yagi, but it is better than having all kind of dips of 20 dB because of mispolarization, and because the elements are shifted on the boom, you need to have the coarse cables the same length. Okay, if you like this kind of experiments, please subscribe to my channel, and hopefully you find more interesting stuff.